All right, some of the best independent films from festivals around the world are going to screen in the Detroit area for 10 days in June. The Cinetopia Film Festival will feature more than 60 films at venues here in Detroit, Ann Arbor, and in Dearborn. Here's a look at one of the documentaries making its Michigan premiere. It is called Step.
Baltimore City.
They come home to no lights, not having food in the refrigerator, not having a refrigerator at all. But when they come to step practice, all of those things are erased out of their mind, so they can make it through life.
You up there screaming and yelling and you just stepping.
We making music with our bodies.
My mother is annoying. And I just be like, Mom, you gotta chill sometimes.
I'm kind of an introvert. I'm just everything that step is not. I'm not very dramatic, but all those parts come out of me when I step.
My mission is to make sure each and every one of you graduates from college.
Are these grades your best? Why does the step team get your best and I don't?
I'm trying.
School is what got me out of Brooklyn. College is what's gonna get you out of Baltimore.
Hands up, don't shoot!
A lot of our children are lost. They have no one. I feel as though it's my obligation to help them.
I'm willing to work because this is not it for me.
It's not the first time the power's been out. I don't want to have to live like this. So I'm going to work my hardest to make it not happen in my life.
I have like two people inside of me that I struggle with every day. One is unstoppable that can do anything. And the other is she feels lost and stuck.
If we don't come together, this girl is not gonna make it.
'Cause the whole world's waiting.
This is way bigger than stepping.
It's about not making excuses. Who you wanna be? Making sacrifices. Having a positive attitude.
If you come together with a group of powerful women, the impact will be immense.
Get to the other side. Know how it feels to fly.
We stand here today on the precipice of the future.
Go, ladies!
Step is life.
All right, that looks like a great film about my other hometown, Baltimore, Maryland. Here to tell us more now about Cinetopia is festival director Caitlin Drzewicki. She's joined by the festival's Detroit Voices coordinator, Jamila Taylor, and Charles Farrell from the Charles H. Wright Museum, one of the screening locations for the festival. Thank you all for being here. Yeah,
thank you very much.
Yeah, yeah. Let's talk about this festival, the idea for this festival. Where does it come from?
So six years ago it started, out of the Michigan Theater in Ann Arbor, mm-hmm. and Russ Collins was the founding father of this festival. There's multiple festivals around the country, and Detroit needs to have its own film festival.
Yeah.
And we go from festival to festival, watch over 400 movies,
yeah.
and it gets simmered down to over 60 films, which you mentioned.
Wow.
Yes, yeah, and we think that these films are going to spark some conversation, make people happy, make people maybe a little teary-eyed,
yeah.
but either way, it's all about the conversation,
yeah.
our community.
Yeah, I mean, is there a unifying theme, would you say, for the films that you're picking?
For this year,
yeah.
We had multiple films actually really discussing the theme of uprising.
Yeah.
And we work with Charles from the Charles H. Wright Museum and also the Arab American National Museum with their festival, the Arab Film Festival. And a lot of these themes come out of a lot of the movies that we've been bringing up. And also a lot of resistance and resilience
yeah.
we've been finding
yeah.
a lot.
Two things that we know a lot about here in mm-hmm. the city of Detroit. Jamila, talk about what this film festival means to a city like Detroit.
For Detroit, it means engaging the community
yeah.
on a deeper level, like having film as a platform to open conversations and dialogue mm-hmm. for change. And again, as our theme this year is Uprise. And with Detroit Voices, it's created by a Sundance alum, Santan Sharif. Mm-hmm. It's a short film competition where our filmmakers get a platform to display their work, get film accolades, and also they're in competition to win $6,000 in cash prizes.
Oh, very
nice. Provided by the Knight Foundation.
Yeah.
So we're really grateful and thankful for them. So this year it's going to be bigger and better than ever. We have three of bigger programs. So we have the Detroit Voices finalists, which is our closing event that will be at the Charles
at the right
Museum,
right.
Absolutely.
Which will be great. And we also have our Detroit Selects and our Detroit Retrospect.
Yeah.
So it's a wide variety of different independent filmmakers that are from the Michigan area.
Right, right. Not all the films are about or from here, right? But some of them are focused on.
Some of them are focused on issues here or stories here or characters, but mainly they are filmmakers and directors that are from the
that
area.
That are from the area.
Yes, from the area.
Yeah, yeah. Talk about the Wright's role in
Well, we're very excited. This is our fourth year of engagement with Cinetopia Film Festival, and our intent is to continue to build upon our previous footprint to expand mm-hmm. our relationship. We're very excited this year to feature some important films such as Whose Streets, mm-hmm. which talks about Ferguson, August 9th, 2014, extrajudicial murder of Michael Brown. Mm-hmm. We're supplementing the Cinetopia by bringing in some speakers. We have Dr. Sundiata Chow-Jow, a professor from University of Illinois, who has expertise in consulting to police departments around the country. And of course, this is part of our larger theme around the Year of Rebellion.
Yes.
That we've developed over 67 programs to lead that discussion. Also, we have a film you're probably familiar with, I Am Not Your Negro, by James Baldwin, narrated by Samuel Jackson. Mm-hmm. This year, we have the biographer of Baldwin, Herb Boyd, who will be in to give some context to that film, as well as to speak later about his groundbreaking book, Black Detroit, People's History of Self-Determination. We also have an important film on Black women in medicine. Of course, you know about Hidden Figures, mm-hmm. but there are some very important women that we'll be discussing in that film. The first orthopedic surgeon, the first surgeon, neurosurgeon in the country. I should say Surgeon General.
Yeah.
And then we're going to close out with Black Color White, which is about someone finding themselves, their identity, a Senegalese who has a French background, who understands his heritage when he returns home.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we're going to close out with Detroit Voices, which premieres a number of Michigan filmmakers.
Yeah.
That should be very, very exciting. And after that, we're inviting the whole community to come out and to party. We're proposing party.
All right.
We have to celebrate this.
Way,
yeah,
right?
we have to celebrate this. So the films allow the theme for Cinetopia from our perspective is to build community.
Yeah.
And we also find it's very important to have some critical analysis around films, to be able to talk to the directors, talk to the scholars, and have a communication dialogue, not just to watch the film and leave.
Yeah.
Although that's rich in itself.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like that is one of the things that we don't give film enough credit for, is its ability to, I mean, this is sort of a cliche, to sort of come off the screen and live with us in real space and time where we can talk about those things.
Not a cliche at all. Yeah. I think it's a great thing to bring the community together, sit in the same room, you feel the same feelings or different feelings, and then you have that conversation afterwards. And it's really about, I heard somewhere that it's like sitting around a bonfire. We enjoy doing that with our peers and our friends.
And think about how often you do that when you just go see a movie.
Right.
This is an anniversary, I won't remember which one, of the movie Do the Right Thing, Spike Lee's movie. And I can remember the night I went to see that. I was a freshman in college, I think, summer of my freshman year. You go see that with six or seven friends. I think we spent the rest of the night talking about what we'd seen on screen, and it changes the way that you think about yourselves and each other and sort of how you relate to the world.
Yes.
Yeah. I would also add that, you know, Detroit has a literacy rate about over 40%.
Mm-hmm.
So we do promote reading. Sometimes films give a context to read, and that's really what we promote, is people to study, to study the history and bring to that some critical analysis, some independent thought. as a way of moving forward. So we will be supplementing the film series with book sales.
Yeah.
So that people have a more critical understanding of what they saw.
Some of the themes.
Some of the themes, with, absolutely.
Yeah. Talk about how the festival has changed. This is the sixth year. Mm-hmm. What was it like on the first year?
Chaotic and crazy. Festivals are inherently really fun, and you kind of have to be quick about it. But I think one of the big changes is that we started working with some of these really wonderful cultural institutions in our community, in our city. So we've been so honored to work with Charles, the Henry Ford, the DIA. That's really how this festival has grown and changed, because we're really engaging with people that we haven't before.
Yeah.
And we're so lucky and just happy to get all these different perspectives. And that's good, that's not good. And
right. That's
like that conversation internally is just as important as when we bring it out into the community.
Yeah, yeah. You were talking earlier about Michigan filmmakers. For a while, we were really excited about film here in Michigan.
With
because, mm-hmm. yeah. Talk about where that all is now. Is it harder to be a filmmaker from Michigan than it used to be?
Well, Michigan, it's a different type of journey being a filmmaker here in Michigan. We are one of the first plateaus where the industry was here with Ford making the most and largest films from the, the big Hollywood conglomerates came here.
Yeah.
And so we have a long history and relationship here in Detroit.
Yeah.
So we have a lot of energy here where people want to stay and grow now with Detroit. It's not like, I'm ready to go. People are really rooting themselves here.
Uh-huh.
So we started a new community with the film festival. The Detroit Film Society is here. There's a lot of MPI, a lot of organizations, and people are really excited, enthusiastic about rooting themselves and making their self accessible to filmmakers and different talents.
I mean, it's an industry where I assume you sort of get started working with other filmmakers and
it's more
grow to be able to make your own. If you sort of yank those filmmakers out, as we kind of did, it makes it more difficult.
Yeah, it makes it more difficult. But with Detroit Voices, it is an opportunity that's not here, where we do have a short film competition where you can not only receive cash prizes, you get those accolades where you can go on and say, hey, I won at a reputable festival, and you're meeting directors, talent, and
And you're getting to learn
experience.
To tell your own story.
Yes.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, congratulations on the sixth annual.
Thanks
for being here.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Before we leave, we want to offer condolences to the family of local educator Dr. Marjorie Harris, who passed away earlier this month. Dr. Harris served 38 years as the president of Lewis College of Business, which was founded by her mother, Violet Lewis. Under Dr. Harris, the school was officially recognized as the only historically black college here in the state of Michigan. Dr. Harris was 92 years old. That's our program for today. Thanks for watching. You can get more information about our guests at AmericanBlackJournal.org. And as always, you can connect with us on Facebook and on Twitter. We'll see you next time.